students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. In today's lecture, we are going to take some more examples on HCF by prime factorization method. Okay, before this, I have given you one video lecture on this HCF by prime factorization method. Also, I have given some examples also to solve. Okay, so some students have confusion. So watch this video very carefully and again revise the process. Okay, so see HCF by prime factorization method. How to find HCF, highest common factor or greatest common divisor, GCD, by prime factorization method. As I told you, prime factorization method means first we have to find the prime factors of the given two numbers, two or three numbers. Okay, there can be three numbers also. So we have to find prime factors first, then we have to take common factors. Okay, and you know HCF means what? Multiplication of only common factors. Okay, so that we are going to do. Just pay attention. First we will find prime factors of 24, okay, and then we will find prime factors of 30. Now see here, prime factors means what? There should be prime numbers. You have to take factors here, only prime numbers, not other than that. And you know the prime numbers 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17 and so on. Okay, there are so many prime numbers, but prime numbers are enough. Now see 24, our first prime number is 2, okay. So let's check whether 24 is divisible by 2 or not. Is 24 divisible by 2? How to identify whether 24 is divisible by 2 or not? Yes. See its last digit is 2, the 4. That means what? It is divisible by 2. Because the number having its units like 0, 2, 6 or 8, those numbers are divisible by 2. So, we'll be right back. and 30 is equal to 2 into 3 into 5. Now see how we have to do the arrangement. Here there is first factor is 2. Is there 2? Yes. So 2 right exactly below the 2 here, which is factor of 24. Then there is 2. Is there 2 more? One more 2 is there in the factor of 30? No. There is 3. Okay. So is here 3? Yes, here. So these 3 will lie below this. And there is 5. So that will lie anywhere. Okay. Now take common factors. Common means the factor of 24 as well as 30. So this 2 and 2 is common in both the numbers. So we'll make box with as well as 3 is also there. Correct? And these 2 are non-common. So we have to take HCF means what? Only common factors, or we can say product of common factors. Product means multiplication. Okay, product of common factors is here. We have got 2 and 3. These 2 don't write twice, right? Take them only once. 2 into here, 3 is common. And multiply this. 3 2s are 6. So 6 is the highest common factor of 24 and 30. Okay? Understood this? Now, it's hot here. Now we will find HCF of 144 and 72. Right? Bigger number we are going to take. See here. First, as usual, first we have to find the prime factors of 144 and prime factors of 72. Now 144. Is it divisible by our first prime number 2? Yes, because last digit is 4. So 144 divided by 2. 2 7s are 40. 2 2s are 4. 72. When you divided 144 by 2, we got answer 72. Okay. Once again, let's check 72 is divisible by 2. Yes, because last digit is 2. Okay. So let's divide 72 by 2. 2 3s are 6. 2 6s are 12. Okay. So 36. Again, 36 is also divisible by 2 because last digit is 6. Okay. See here. Here I want only prime numbers as factors, not other than that. I don't want their 4, 6, 8, 9 this way. There must be 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29. Like these prime numbers should be there as factors, okay? Otherwise, you will think that yes, 36 is in table of 6, so you take 6 here. No, this is not prime number. Okay, 2. Now, if you divide 36 by 2, what you will get? 18 2s are 36, correct? If you know the table of 18, 18 2s are 36. Again, 18 is divisible by 2. 2 9s are 18. 9 is divisible by which prime number? 3. 3 3s are 9. And 3 is prime number itself, so it will be divisible by itself. 3 1s are 3. Okay? Now 72. Already we have 72 is here, right? So all these factors, prime factors are of 72. 72 divided by 2, 36. 36 divided by 2, 18. 18 divided by 2, 9. 3 3s are 9. And 3 1s are 3. Okay, so these are prime factors of 72. So let's write here 144 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times 2 and 2 times 3. 2 times 3, okay. Now, 72. 1, 2, 3, 3 times 2. 2, 2, 2. Into 2 times 3. Now, see, this 3 we will write exactly below this 2, 3, okay. finish. Now let's see common factors. 2 and 2. 2 and this 2. This 2 and this 2. Now here for this 2 there is no common factor. 3 is common. Okay. And this 3 and this 3. And you know HCl means? HCl of 144 and 72 is equal to, you know, HCl means product of common factors. So now this I will not write directly. Multiply the common factors. It's 2, 2, 2. 3 times 2 and 3, 3. 2 times 3. So 3 3s are 9, 9 2s are 18, 18 2s are 36, 36 2s are 72. 72 is the highest common factor or greatest common divisor of 144 and 72. Why 72 is highest common factor? See now, this 72 is divisible by 72, 72 1s are 72 and 144 is also divisible by 72. 72 2s are 144, 2 2s are 4, 2 7s are 14, 144. Correct? So, the GCD or HCF of 144 and 72 is nothing but 72 itself. Okay? So, whenever the shortcut I will tell you here, two numbers are there, right? If the smaller number, in the table of smaller number, if the greater number is there, that or the greater number is divisible by smaller number, when two numbers are given to find HCF, if greater number is in table of smaller number, then that smaller number is itself a HCF. Okay, as we have seen here, 72 is HCF of 144. Another example I am giving you, if there is this way, 30 and 50. Now see, 30 is in table of 15, right? And 15 is in table of 15 itself. So the GCD is nothing but 15. Okay? So these two examples we have seen today. Write this in your notebook. And two examples I am giving you to solve during this period only. So find HCF of it. Okay, find HCF of these two, 64-128 and 98-150. Okay, so these two examples solved during today's maths period. Write this in your notebook. Okay, hope you understood now. Practice this thoroughly, watch the video properly, carefully, understand, and then solve these two examples without seeing any this video. Okay, so thank you for today. Have a nice day.